sat tado. Hakuna otherwise.
Adulthood is a scam.
Hata nikijambia, maybe I should just stop beating myself up.
Bye-bye. But I'm waiting red because it's a movie night for Valentine's edition, something of the sort. Aki si kuna vitu mi, aki what's being a girl? In a boo. But again, where one or two people gather, inenda gaji. At the reason you don't have... Wow.
Hi guys. Hi. It's so awkward to start a video, okay? Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking onto this video. If you're new here, my name is Nicole Nazoe, but if you like it, you can call me Libre Bew. Please remember to like this video, subscribe, and leave a sweet comment, even if it's just those red little tiny cute hearts. I will really appreciate it. How are you guys doing? Like, how is 2023 so far for you? Are you feeling the year, or it's just a bit ish? For me, I feel like it's a bit ish, cause I'm just taking the days as they're coming. Yeah, I've not yet planned out my year, but I know what I want to do. But I'm still taking every day as it comes. Anyway, today is a sweet Wednesday. I just woke up. I'm taking my breakfast, which is omelette and 4 slices of bread. Today my spread is honey. I love Blue Band on my bread because I feel like honey is just too sweet. But find me hiding in the kitchen licking our honey. I love it when it's plain, but on bread, I feel like it's just too sweet. Omelette, I've been making omelettes of late. Anyway, eggs are healthy, I bet. Eggs are healthy. And my cup of cocoa. Yeah, chocolate, yeah. So, I want to watch Kim Kardashian. You know those mornings when you wake up and your favorite creators have their videos up? I love, like, my mornings are normally YouTube mornings. And then nowadays, of late, my nights have become movie nights. Yeah. Anyway, guys, this video, I've just introduced it here because I don't have a video going on. I love clapping. I don't have a video going on yet, but yeah, let's introduce. I'm supposed to dye my hair in this video. We're supposed to go with my friend to Two Rivers, I think. I don't think we have another venue, but this year we must source out for venues. What else am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to wash our car, which already it's looking like it's not gonna happen, but yeah, you have to take a star. What else? I think Nizo too. But I hope you're going to enjoy the video. Please watch till the end because we are trying to work on our watch hours, but we are almost okay. Coach hours kidogo. Please watch till the end. Watch all my videos till the end, or as much as you can, you know. Because again, I can't force you to watch till the end. But the fact that you're already watching, I really appreciate it. But try watch for more minutes as you can. Yeah. Let me enjoy my breakfast. Then I get to work. Because, yo, the house is so dirty. So I want to clean the house today, but I'm not going to do it with you guys because filming while cleaning, it's a lot of work. So I'm going to clean, then do utensils. I think I'll start with the utensils, then clean the house, alafu nifanye nini. I'm supposed to go buy my hair dye. Okay, what is adulthood? Kitambo ulikuwa tu unaamka breakfast ndio hiyo. If it's about the hair, your mom got you, you know, they undo your hair. You go to the salon, it's all done. Like nowadays, we have to wash our own hair. We have to book for our own salon appointments. But I'm not complaining. Well, I'm lucky complaining, but satutado. Hakuna otherwise. Anyway, guys, please watch till the end. I hope you've already liked this video to this point. I'll see you when I see you. This is days later. I guess more than 4 days or roughly 4 days. It's 6:34 p.m. and I received a call from our youth pastor, our church youth pastor, akinitafuta because I've been missing in action. let me be honest. I've been going through tough times. Where yo apana. Adulthood is a scam. Adulthood is definitely a scam. So I'm actually late. Alikuwa amenipigia asking where I have been. Plus they have this movie night, like the youth, they have this movie night, and she told me to go. I really had a lot that I was doing. I actually dropped what I was doing and I didn't start getting ready immediately because she called me at around 4:20 or something, 4:15 hapo. And I told her that I'm not promising. I love the guilt of telling someone from like church that, but it's rather saying, it's best saying the truth than a lie, right? So I've been putting this on, I think, for the last 3 days on my face, and I love this soft touch it gives me. I want to be consistent for a week, then I see how everything will turn out. Anyway, let me get my products as I'm talking to you guys. I was saying, Kwanza, I was meant to clean this place because it's dusty. Najua dust. This place is so dusty. It looks like vile kuna kanga Rongai watu huko. I hear there's so much dust in Rongai, so I don't know. But I've been there, it's so dusty. But nowadays it's dusty almost everywhere. What was I even saying? Oh yeah. So when she called me, okay, my pencil is so small. I'm supposed to go to Dubois. I've been saying this the whole of January imeisha. Last niliingia tao ilikuwa sijui. I don't even think it's in December. Oh yeah, early December. So I couldn't say like no to her, you know. But I went and asked my mom, because how did she know I'm at home? I went and asked my mom, kwani uliambia Pastor Anna nipigie? She's called Pastor Anna. And I was like, mom, asema tu ukweli. Because you know, one thing I tell my mom, and I feel so bad saying this, but I have to say it, you know, it's facts, is I'm not a teen anymore. I'm not like 21, 22 years old. You know, I'm older. And when I wake up in the morning, I have my own schedule, right? I have things on my to-do list. I have to do those things. And I'm this person, siku ikisha kama sijafanya kitu fulani, the guilt that will kill me and the fact that I've wasted minutes and hours in that day to not do my stuff, I just feel so bad. So I went and told my mom and asked her kama ni yeye. She told our pastor to call me anitafute. But anyway, it's fine, you know. Let's go and see how it will be. I'm sure it will be nice. I actually love our church activities because they're so nice. And they put a lot of thoughts and effort into such things. So I'll give you guys the feedback when I'm back. Ilianza 5 and it's ending at 8, according to what the pastor told me. Yeah, it's ending at 8:80 African time. So probably Taisha 9, 9:30. You guys, you know, Africans, African timing. We literally have our own time scheme. So, as I was saying, I've been struggling because I was even telling this to my cousin. We were having a conversation on how far, like, we feel the year is to us, and I was telling her that personally, I feel like when Cookie was eating my brush, I'm yucky, this dog. I feel like things are really slowing down, like things are really going slow. And I'm this person who really beats myself up. At this point, if you're not new in this channel, I beat myself up for a lot of reasons. Every time, everything, I just feel like I'm never doing enough as I'm supposed to. So I was telling her that I feel like I'm not achieving stuff. Vitu tu zinaenda pole pole. Like January imeisha and I don't feel like I've done anything at all, at all, at all. But you know, as I was showering, I was like, but you've been creating content. But this week I only posted one video. I feel so bad. Yeah, so when I was showering, I was actually looking at it and I'm like, but you've been creating content. I've been consistent as far as I know. And maybe it should just stop. Anyway, ata nikijambe, maybe I should just stop beating myself up. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. So I don't know what I want even to do. But me, I just feel like things are going slow and I don't know things in what way. But for example, when I was in therapy last year, I realized that everything has a route to it. Maybe I don't know what I want to happen, but na feel two vitu zinaenda pole pole, maybe because your stuff ija happen, which in real sense is I've not gone to any restaurant yet. Sijafanya any restaurant reviews. Sijaenda Gikomba for my hauls, and I was like, this year we're doing hauls, this year we're doing and I've not done anything. So I asked myself, what is stopping me from doing this? Look at how Cookie bites off things. She bit off this conceal of mine. You can not mashimo. Ata ukifinya, instead of coming out here, it comes out from this pose. Anyway, so okay, this is too much. I don't know what's holding me back from kuamka tu nitoke niseme leo naenda Gikomba. I'm going to buy this and this or whatever today, next week. Next content itakuwa hii na hii. So me, I just don't know. I don't know. But one thing I know has demotivated me from creating this week is hata nikiombea mtu na tu ni ufala. I swear. Takwa like, no girl, you're being petty. But to be honest, I haven't washed our car. I said I'm going to do that in the beginning of this video. Actually, I was supposed to delete that intro and just start a whole video next week. Because next week I have a busy week. And I was just about to delete this whole video and everything. And then we had guests around. And with me, with people around, I find it really, really hard to create. May we get our own house, inshallah. I'm not saying this in a bad way, because home is really amazing. Najwata, when I get my own place, I'll always be here. Maybe, I don't know. But I really, really love our house. But you see, when people are around, mostly it's different when my cousins are around, because my cousins uneza wambia, hey, kaini yuko ni nini. But these were my mom's friends. And it's hard to, like, I don't know, Missy Dream. It was just difficult to create and stuff. So I haven't been creating. Sijaosha gari. I've not I didn't arrange my closet. So ata sai nikitoizi nguo, I was just so frustrated because my tops are just all over disorganized. Everything is just disorganized. I need to change my bed sheets. I was to do that today, but I've already told my pastor I'll be there. It's 6:47. Say in under 7. I'll be there for like 1 hour, maybe 2. AT African time. But anyway, life is all about trial, and at some point I was like, "Nindi aman isiende," you know, I can just decide to not go and finish everything that I had planned to do for today. But then I was like, "This is what you normally do," and I don't get things done because I feel like I prioritize other things that they shouldn't be prioritized, and I end up not doing what I was supposed to do. I don't know if that makes sense. Like anyway, like growing up, you have to decide your life. There's no one to do that for you. Like sika kitambu ulikunamka, unambandu woge. Unaoga, kidogo chai ndo yu iko served. Yeah? Now you can go play, kidogo unaitwa for lunch. Yo, life was sweet. Life was sweet when you were kids. But now, atuna otherwise, ukikuwa mgonjwa unajipeleka hosi. Mi kwanza the first time I took myself to hospital, I was like, enyewe nimekuwa mkubwa. I think I even cried. I was like, guy, yani mom hunipeleki, but my mom doesn't even know I cried. I remember I cried on my own. I was like, wah, najipeleka hosi. Anyway, I feel like growing up is a bittersweet experience. You know, adulthood rather. It's just a bittersweet experience, and you have to find your own way to enjoy, because you can't be sad forever. You can't be blaming people forever for what's happening in your life. You just have to get your own shit together and move on, you know. Just take life as it comes. Anyway, guys, Mr. Kipongiasana, I feel like I've not done my eyebrows vizuri, but I'm done with everything. The only thing I'm going to do is put my shoes on, and I've not even eaten. Look, like, my makeup is over. Sijui I just wear my foundation, but I kwanza kutafuta vitu sai. This is just the makeup I keep close. Like, it's my everyday makeup. I use concealer so much, and that's why it's easy kwa karibu before nianze kutafuta foundation. In your time, but it's better off appearing today other than not at all, you know. Maybe ata bwanangu ako huko, you never know, you just don't know. Speaking of which, next week will be a very busy week. I think I've said that I'm supposed to do my nails because I'll be going to official places. Nah, I don't want to miss my opportunity. Maybe my future husband loves a neat girl. So I want to get my nails and toes done. I do that by myself. Ndio tukwe ready for next week. Makucha, I think I'll do them tomorrow. Yeah. Today I'm just doing a very shoddy makeup. I've not eaten. I think I'll have to go buy a bag of fries and just munch before nifike. You see now, if our kind get kuimoshwa, nikuichukua tu na kutoka. But sasa, nikutembea. But thank God our church is not far from where we live. It's like a 7-minute walk. Acha nizime laptop cycles. Anyway, guys, how's your nini coming along? How's your February coming along? How's your year coming along? Me, I have so much stress because my phone is not charging. I think the charging port in Arabica, it's even at 30%. Nandu mimi naongea. I've already talked for more than 10 minutes. Let me go, guys. I need an... I forgot to spray myself. I need a memory card. Ningine na need. I need to do a lot of things. I just need to do a lot of things. That's all I know. A lot of things are waiting for me, child. Hey, I've started parting this instead of my eyebrows. I can't do multiple things at once. Now I'm doing my makeup, I'm talking, I'm vlogging. I keep checking my phone if it's still recording because I remembered there's a whole video, a whole 30-something minute video I've not deleted from my phone because I already posted it. So I didn't delete it. I have to delete it to create more space. But isi mime ni serve, lakini sahi I just feel like imeanza tu kunibu. Inanibu. Inabu. My cousin says that, hey, yo ni bamba. We, I have such amazing cousins. And I thank God for them. Yeah, I thank God that my best friends are my cousins.
So let me do this quick, and then I just check out of the house. I'll see you guys when the whole thing is over to just close off this vlog. Yeah. Thank you for watching to this point. Please remember to like, subscribe if you haven't. I'll see you guys for the update. Yeah. Bye bye. I am finally done. I washed my hair the other day, but I want to go to town to buy my hair dye because I think it's cheaper there. The last time I bought dye, ile chakukwa 50 anymore. Like, sijui waliniambia, sijui ni 60 and 70, but when I was like, huh? What do you mean? And for a box of, I don't know, is it 20 or 30 pieces in town? We buy for 300 shillings. So imagine I spend like 100 bobot more to just buy two hair dyes. Then if you get that too, so we can get that big box. You understand? But anyway, since it's a night stuff, but then I'm wearing red because it's a movie night for Valentine's edition, something of the sort. Don't play with our church. Don't play. They are extra. Just like the church goes there. Anyway, this is what I have worn. I've never worn this top. It's very new. And a pair of jeans and my white nini, lakini mwezi wana chini. Plus it's late, so I won't even take a photo. But let me just pause for my thumbnail. Hope my hair is messy. Aki content creation. Kai, alafu mnakosa ku like. Aki like this video. Just like, and not just this video. Any video of mine that you click, please like. Earrings. Hey, you see? I need to get more earrings. Aki si kuna vitu mi. Aki, what's being a girl? Inabu too. Hi, Bambi. Swingy. I feel so bad for being late, but niliambiwa late, and plus since I already said yes, see, better late than never. Nifike tu, I do what nitapata watu wakifanya, and yeah, nitasema nilikuwa. Anyway, I'll see you guys. Oh, I was posing for my thumbnail. Bye guys. I'll give you the feedback on how everything will go. Okay, hope sequel and make out for most of this whole time I've been talking. Anyway, I'll see you guys.
Change. Oh, Juliet, you're there. Yes, let me see.
So guys, I just arrived. Not yet, but I'm from church and it's around 9:13 p.m. So I told you to totoka 9 or 9:30 African time. Yeah, you know the way they usually say EAT, East African time. In Africa, it's just say it Africa time, African time. Like these stairs. It was so amazing. Imagine, so the registration fee for the movie night, Valentine's edition. I'm so unfit. It was, I think, 50 bob kama sijakosea. The youth walikuwa na 50 bob. And personally, Miss Kitwa, I'm not going to lie. Because I wasn't planning to go, but then our pastor called and was like, you know what, probably this is just, it's God. You know how God does things to get you out of your comfort zone? I took it as that. And that's why I had to drop everything and just go. Yeah, and it was such an amazing, let me get to the house. Then I tell you, when did I say, anyway, I've been unfit. Nisha Africa, let me get to the house. I put the ring light on. I just arrived. I saw that video, it just gets the best out of me. Wah! Anyway, I can e-vlog, or at an e-vlog. one thing, if you do lifestyle vlogs, ata kama it's a video and umefanya hiyo siku moja, you'll call it a vlog by mistake, one way or the other. Guys, by the way, I need my laptop keyboard to be cleaned. I've spilled so many things on it. I even wonder how it functions. Wah! Okay, you're a survivor, darling. I love this laptop so much. It was a gift. I was telling you guys, nilikuwa naomba ni hata nimesahau. But anyway, I really had an amazing time. Nilifika when it was like, I think I've said this. Like the movie ilikuwa imeenda for like 30 minutes. But they had a bag of popcorns. They had juice. Like, you know, those plastic cups that people normally sell juice in, juices like a 50 bob and 100. So that cup for like 50 bob, those juice, and everyone was given. Well, me, I missed, was in Lifika when it was too late. So if they were there early, that's what they were given. And you can imagine, for popcorns and juice alone, and for registration fee for the movie night, ilikuwa 50 bob. You, please. If you live near us, or if you just want to come to our church one Sunday, it doesn't matter where you live, just hit me up. You know, our church is very, very amazing. Everyone that visits us, and I go with them to the youth church, they just love our church, you know. But I hope you guys will enjoy this video. Yeah. I really thank God my pastor came through with that call. I feel like, I don't even know what to say. I feel like it got me out of my comfort zone. And if I could have missed it, Menigelia, you guys should watch that movie. It is called, can you imagine, or can I imagine? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. And it's actually a true life story that was acted. Kai. I'm going to rewatch it. It's a Christian-based movie. And it's about, let me just give you the brief. Araka, araka. It's about this boy. It's a kid who later on obviously grew into a man. He was raised by the dad. I don't know where the mom went, because nilipata again. Movie ilikuwa imeanza. So I don't know what happened to the mom. But I'm going to search for that movie. Anyway, this boy, he had dreams, I think, of becoming a great musician. You know, akwe anaimba kwa stage, he's getting deals, nini nini, and he's singing, he sang gospel songs. That artist, siju jina yake, but there's a, that gospel song, I definitely know it, not by word, but I know it juu najua nimesha isikia mahali. So, see, this boy, he had a really, really abusive father. Like, alikuwa na mchapa, alikuwa na mbia the dad vile, he wants to one day become those great artists, kuimba. And the dad was like, dreams are not valid. Dreams take you nowhere. Like, he used to shatter him. Every time the dad had a bad day out there, he'd come and beat the boy up just to let his frustrations out of him. And that's what you normally say before you become a parent. Please heal. I don't think kids deserve a bitter mom or dad just because you went through what you went through in life, and then unakuja kutolea some innocent lives because you, a partner maybe broke you, you're just angry at your kids for nothing, because maybe your relationship with your workers at work, or with your co-workers, or with your parents is not, or even your siblings is not stable enough. You can't remove your frustrations into your children, or maybe work didn't go as you planned. You know, they're just things that happen, and you find that there are such parents who go and demean their children's dreams and everything. So anyway, this dad was like, Akuna, there's nothing like that that is happening, okay? Dreams are not valid. And as Lupita Nyong'o said, my darlings, dreams are very much valid. Anyway, so siku moja, anyway, that so as the boy grew up, nini nini, he had this bitter thing into his dad. He couldn't forgive him, nini nini. So akaenda kwa gari. You know this, what are they called? Where wazungu anaekanga hapo juu, whatever, the keys. So akaenda akafungwa hivi. Akapata a note from the hospital showing that the dad was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. So he felt so bad. And then they were from having an argument because the dad was like, he wants to make new memories. He was starting to like try to get closer with their son. But according to the son, he was like, I can't forgive you. When and who caused you? It was such an interesting movie. But at the end, the dad died. But after they created memories, they went for rides. He loved rides, these car rides with the son. And they went for those rides. He went back to church. He asked the son for forgiveness. The son learned to forgive him. Guys, any name to your movie. It's called I Can Only Imagine. And what I picked from that is, don't let anyone, because at the end of the day, this boy who later on, Alisa at this point was like a big man who I think he got married. He became one of the greatest gospel artists. Yeah? And he died in 1997. I can't even watch your movie. So one thing I learned is that your dreams are valid. Don't let anyone shatter your dreams, because this boy had a parent. Imagine having a parent who doesn't believe in your dream. And akwambia, that's bullshit. There's akuna kitu kama hiyo, by the way. And you're not going to be successful. You're stupid. Sijuini, can you imagine? Anyway, I learned that good things take time. Because he didn't become a great artist at itu mara moja. Obviously, kuna zile trials and failures, which later on became success and made him the big person that he is. Always trust your gut. Don't let anyone shatter your dreams. Always keep God close, because he was a very godly person. Ever since alikuwa mtui. Alikuwa naenda this Christian camps and everything. Mi hata sienangi hizi vitu za church. My events. But it's never, most of the times it's not out of bad will or anything. It's because okay, you're just packed. But there are times you should actually create time for God. Because I was telling myself when I was coming to the house, I was like, imagine you saying, kwe akini mekwa busy, ata sijakwa nikienda church, ata sina excuse. Imagine Mungu akusahau tuju akona vitu zingine. We have, sijui how many billions, even I don't know how many people we are in this world. Tuko wengi. So imagine if God akusahau tu, ata si tutakufa. Autaamka. Mungu akwele, we, I forgot about person A. Can you imagine? So I feel like God really does a lot for us. And one thing I've learned this year is, well, I've been reading the Bible almost every day. Yeah, like this week's just a matter once. And I want to change my routines like so much. Most of the times when I listened to songs while doing my chores, sometimes I find myself listening to preachings, and I learn a lot. I'm learning patience. I'm learning that good things take time. That's the biggest lesson I learned last year to Kenya this year. So anyway, aki video zangu sikizi tu ni ma pep talks. Lakini I hope it also encourages someone, because also me, I'm being encouraged. Every day of my life, I'm being encouraged. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. I had an amazing day. I won't lie. I can't wait for the next event. Yeah. If I'll make it. I hope I will make it. Tomorrow I have to make my nails. Tomorrow is Sunday. Yeah. I'm going to make my nails, my toes, because next year we are looking stunning. We can't afford to look shabby next week. We can't afford to look shabby, so I have to make my nails and my toes. Yeah. Anyway, guys, I hope you're going to have an amazing week, because this video, inshallah, it's going to go up on Monday. It will be a busy day, but I hope it will go up on Monday. I have to edit it. That means I have to. Sunday is zinakwanga tu za ku edit videos on Monday. And at times even the Wednesday's video, as in Sunday is usually my reset date for the week, reset day. There's also my fellow, a friend of mine from church, alikuwa anasema Sunday zinafanyanga nini sijaiko da church. And that's when I was like, nikampe excuse, you know. I was like, Sunday nakwanga sikianga ya kureset, nini nini. I edit most of my videos. Nafanyanga nini, like, I do my nails mostly on Sundays. I do my bed mostly on Sundays, like, changing the bed sheets. I put my clothes together on Sunday. Like, Sunday nakwanga to my day of arranging my life before the week starts, you know. So, nikamwambia hivyo. And then now, when I was walking home, ndo nikajiuliza wa. I just give an excuse, but imagine when God is kumaja kwa like, akisi nimes how about Nicole? Unajua, ninge kwa nime daddy. But he's never forgotten about me, though I'm giving excuses of not going to church. I should change that. Lakini, one thing about me, even if I don't go, I will make sure I will listen to Bambika, inetongo Bambika, yeah, on Citizen. And if not that, our church usually has a live, whatever. They go live for their services, so I have to catch up with them. I'm a UAR TV, a Citizen. But life is life. At the end of the day, yet I don't praise God. But again, where one or two people gather, inendangaji. Usually, it's where one or two people gather. No, I'm there. I can see you. I'm not even at a stubborn this year. Please write it on the comment section. I've forgotten how it goes. Anyway, we should stop giving excuses. Me kwanza, I hate it when people are like, ata fadhali yangu lakini. But no sin is smaller or bigger than the other. Wait. See, I told you guys, it takes me an hour to finish. I drink like a bottle of water per hour. If I'm not drinking much, one bottle of water per every 2 hours. But you see? In images of Lenny may come. What was I saying? I'm always just me to always forget what I was saying when I divert. If it took a doggo, Nivo. Was it about going to church? I think I'll check. I've remembered. I've checked. I won't say I hate, because hate is a very strong word. I just dislike that. Tabia, I don't like it when people say that they don't go to church because Christians wanakuanga very mean people, like they're pretenders, exactly. I don't like this lighting even. And Christians, they don't go to church because Christians are very mean people, judgmental. And I'm like, when you go to church, is it those people that you're going to be praising, or is it your Lord? Okay, so yeah, you just go to church, you know your aim, ukoni praising the Lord. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I hope you're learning something and you're enjoying the video. Leave a comment down below if I've said something that is mean or I've put anything in a bad way. Let me know in the comment section. Yeah. Plus, I wanted to share this. These people, there's this meme that I normally see. Ati, the reason mbona hauna partner. Ati, the reason you don't have... Wow. At the reason you don't have a partner, it's because immediately after the service, unakwanga kwanza kuenda home. That is so me. Kuna mtu aliniona during the service, but after two, tumemaliza hivi, by the time you're like, siko hapo, I'm not there. I find it, I'm such an introvert. I don't know how to behave when I'm in a crowd of so many people, or just a number of people. I don't know how to talk. I don't know how to behave. I don't know. Natakanga tu, okay, we are done. Minaenda. Tumemaliza. Minaenda. Socializing. Wah. I'm such an introvert. Hey. But, to some, it comes out rudely, like, ule mtu anajifanya, sijui nini. But to be honest, I don't know how to old conversations. I'm so weird when it comes to conversing. I'm so weird when it comes to bringing up topics. I'm just, I don't know. How do you extroverts do it? Like talking socially. My mom is such an extrovert. Wah! You know those parents after the service, munezaka 30 minutes to even an hour, akisalimia watu. Munasonga to be, yeah. That's my mom. But funny thing is, her children, all of us, we are such silent people. Like, watu wanajuanga tu, mama yetu ndo akona watoto wapole. Because we are such silent people. My sisters are so silent. I think our last born yendo yujaribu, but she's some sort of extrovert. But sisi wengine, but she's growing. I feel like she's growing into an introvert. Because sikuizi she's a bit composed, kidogo. I don't know, but my brother is such a silent person. Mimi, my sister mwenye ananifuata, another silent case. It's funny. It's fun. Life is just funny. But anyway, guys, okay, acha tu nione tomorrow as I'm signing off the video and showing you my cute nails. So keep watching. I'll see you guys tomorrow and have a fruitful week. Yeah. Bye. Happy Valentine's. I hope I'm gonna Valentine's. I don't know. I don't have. My mom will be my Valentine. So come back to watch that video. Okay. Come back to watch that video.